Right, so the stage is set for our first panel of the day, who will be talking about creating sustainable content play. This session, ladies and gentlemen, will be moderated by Mr. Arnab Mitra, Managing Director, Liquid Asia Worldwide. Let's welcome him with a round of applause. And I'd now go ahead and welcome our panel members for the session. Mr. Akash Banerjee, Head Marketing and Partnerships, Wycom 18 Digital Ventures, Boot. We will also be joined by Mr. Manish Agarwal, Business Head, Z5 India. And Ms. Neha Warrior, Vice President, Sales India, Myriad. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our first panel of the day. Let's start with a huge round of applause for them. And Mr. Mitra, over to you.
Thank you. So we got a very interesting panel today. So I think it's a great start that we had already to the day, with Mr. Krishnan's presentation. I think we have a $1 million topic to discuss today. Whatever we are seeing around us, entire about the OTT platforms and the content and everything that's being created, is that sustainable? And how can we actually go ahead and keep sustaining this entire model? So I will just begin the discussion, and I actually have fantastic panels over here. I have got Akash from Voot, I have got Manish from Z5, I have got Neha from Myriad, and I represent an advertising agency. So I think we are trying to get a very well-rounded point of view about the fact that the Indian industry, the media industry, actually continues to be contradictory. On one side, we have not just Indian players, but of course the international players like Netflix and Amazons of the world investing a lot of money in creating content. And second, on the other side, we also have free-to-air television channels which are continuing to connect to the deeper parts of the society. And what we're trying to understand from this is that while we keep on getting a lot of people using all these platforms and they're using the data platforms to consume the content, is it really making sense? Because every time when we are seeing bigger content plays like the Sacred Games of the world, we see significant amount of growth in terms of the consumption. What about the other smaller content players? There are about 25 OTT players at this point in time in the country. We would possibly know only 5-6 of them. Like, we can just do a vote here and you will understand only. We would only know top 5-6. What is happening on the other sides? A lot of our content is ad-free and we are spoiled by the likes of Netflix. And therefore, will consumers actually like when advertisements actually happen on this platform? And there is significant amount of investment in creating content. Are brands, really making money? While I kind of not give my point of view here at this point in time, I would open the panel to, starting with, Manish yourself, that what is your thought on this and how do you think this industry is going to shape up?
Thanks, Arnab. I think overall OTT as a category, like you rightly mentioned, has about 24, 25 players right now, right? But what's critical is that if you look at from a consumer perspective, today, and more so today, Indian consumer is very, very hungry for good content. And more importantly, if that content is offered in the language of your choice, that becomes very critical. So, and in fact, that's exactly even if you look at from what we at Z5 are trying to do, we're trying to offer consumer content in the language of their choice. What we've witnessed is that this category is growing, and of course everybody's interest in this category, it's largely driven by the fact that consumer has the appetite. I mean, we were discussing even backstage. If you look at today, Indian consumer is spending about 8 gigabytes of data. I mean, on their mobile phones, and about 4 hours per day on the mobile phone is being spent. So clearly, if you look at it from, a few years ago, this number was not even about 300 MB of data. So as a category, thanks to smartphone penetration, thanks to, low data costs, we are seeing huge traction.
Great. Akash, what's your thoughts?
Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. Let me start off with a quote that Charles Dickens made close to two centuries back when he said, it was the best of the times and it's the worst of the times. And I think that line never held truer than what we are all experiencing today. It's a great bonanza time for the consumers at large. Massive explosion of devices, surplus of content, new and varied kind of formats, ad-free experience, subscription experience. The time for the consumers has never ever been better. But why is it also the worst of the times? One, at a platform level, for all the platform owners, the monetization challenge continues to be a huge impediment for them to be able to achieve critical scale for their platform. And for the consumers, it has become a huge concern area with so much of choice of content, with the abundance of content, it has indeed become a battle for attention. But the rules of the game are very, very simple. The best story wins. The most riveting story wins. The most relevant story wins. And the rest is all complete noise. And as platform owners at Voot, even on the back of 35 million plus odd active users, monthly users, more than 5 to 6 billion minutes of watch time, we have seen a massive growth in the overall engagement of consumers on our platform with more than 5x growth. But the challenges are for real. The challenge of being able to monetize this vast expanse of content. Second, helping consumers discover the kind of content that they wish to see. Third, primarily being if India is a country of countries, right? How do you dish out? How do you serve different kind of consumers sitting in different geographies at scale? Just by having X number of pieces of content in regional languages or having Y number of pieces of content for the new set of rural consumers or tier 2, tier 3 consumers, is that enough to really shape the industry at a scale that we think it should be? And these are challenges that I think not just Voot, Z5, pretty much every platform is currently experiencing. And of course, one of the things that Manish also spoke about, what is the experience that you're going to give? Are consumers willing to pay? Is AWOD the way forward? Or is SWOD the way forward? Or dabbling with both, which is freemium, the next model that's going to make consumers convert more, make get consumers to spend more time on your platform? These are questions, these are challenges that we're all experiencing, but I am more than happy to say, and the fact of the matter is, there are no right answers. And we were in fact discussing in our speaker's lounge, the only answer very truly is that we all need to keep on trying out different business models, and that's about it.
So Akash, thank you. Neha, I would like to understand from you, while Akash wants us to keep on experimenting, we still have to make money. How do you make money?
Hi, good afternoon, everybody. I think like the two of my other panelists have already mentioned that viewers' behaviors have completely changed in the recent past and faster than what we could think. And this presents the real challenge for brands as to how to really reach out to the audiences today. And if you see the general trends today, not only in terms of catch-up TV on OTT platforms, which is really huge, there is original content and numbers are there to speak for themselves. Almost $500 million being parked aside for original content in India, and that clearly is the future. But having said that, the OTT platform viewers are today totally spoiled for a non-disruptive experience. And going forward, however hybrid you would want to be, time has told us that whenever a richer experience of viewing has come our way, we've always taken that. And I think that is a non-intrusive ad model. And that's where we really fit in, because we are completely platform agnostic. We work with the linear channels, which come on catch-up TV. But at the same time, we are with the biggest OTT players, providing a unique and an extremely superior technology of in-video advertising, which is highly contextual. And it's actually not a product placement model. It's extremely different way of monetizing your content. The turnaround time is actually a week. But having said that, we completely keep the ethos of the content in place. And we place brands across thousands of episodes and not just one, which is a product placement model. And I think that is the future. In India, while we've tied up with Star, which is one of the biggest networks, in China, we are working with the biggest of the digital platforms like Youku, Tencent, and the kind of campaigns that we have run out there have been extremely successful, which are completely in-video campaigns. And I think that's in future, apart from subscription model, ads running within the content and outside, they're all going to coexist. But more so, the ad unit of running in the breaks is going to decline as a currency of and a good quality exposure of in-video running within the content is going to go up. And that's a great monetization model going forward.
Great. So I think we have heard from all the panelists in terms of their opinion on OTT. I think we would get into a little more specifics over here. Akash, just starting from you, because you spoke on experiences, you spoke about how we need to create content and we need to keep the quality of the content in a pivotal position. So as an organization, as Voot, what kind of strategies do you have in terms of creating content, which are your highlight content and your regular content?
Look, it all starts with the consumer segmentation. And I think as a marketer, it's so heartening to see that few rules of the game, they still hold intact, right? At Woot, what we very clearly see are four very different kind of consumer segments. The first segment, they are still your hardcore TV loyalist. Just before I talk about it, Voot essentially has thousands and thousands of hours of content, A, from the world of the Viacom 18 network, which is your Colors, MTV, Nickelodeon, Colors, Gunner, etc., and a lot of original content that we also create. So the first segment are very clearly the TV loyalists who would essentially have a huge affinity towards watching TV content on TV. The only reason when they would come on Voot would be if they end up missing out on the episodes. So it's a very catch-up behavior that gets exhibited. And hence, how do you ensure that the right kind of episode, the right kind of content is shown to that specific consumer segment? The second is there are a lot of consumers who I call as the digital dabblers. They end up watching the full episodes on TV, but to watch a lot of exclusive content, they come on Voot. This is what we do on the back of our Big Boss, our Roadies and Splitsville, a lot of the reality shows. The third segment is there is now this growing base of consumers who have started possibly watching not just the missed out episodes, but the entire pieces of shows, the entire content piece on Voot itself. And the fourth one, who I call as the digital first audiences, they are in need of experiencing and consuming very differentiated kind of content, which is not your typical 30-minute episode with a very specific kind of narrative, which is not necessarily made for the lowest common denominator as far as India is concerned, but very strong, slightly more urban at times, which could also be tier two, tier three kind of audience segments. But for them, digital is the first medium where they go out and see the content that they wish to see. But I think the biggest concern that all the platforms are currently facing is on the point of discoverability, right? Because mass entertainment in this new digital age, unfortunately, is still about blockbusters and not about endless choice.
Actually, that's the point. You know, I think you hold the thought over there. In fact, you spoke about digital first, and you speak about the blockbusters, you know. And Manish, I want to understand from you that how do you look at this original content? Because what we are getting is pretty much original content is driving this entire space, and not just original content. We are talking about high budget, high production value content, right? So how do you sustain this, really?
Sorry, you know, before before Manish says talks about it, I just want to make one point. You know, the word originals is actually a misnomer, okay? Every content that, whether it's Viacom 18 or Z is making, even for the TV networks, even that is original.
Right.
What is an original? Original is something which is not fake or which is not available in multiple platforms.
No, I think original is created from that particular platform.
So I guess it's more about a digital first content, maybe for the new digital first consumers.
Yeah, so I would just add to what Akash mentioned. So for I would say for us at Z5, three-pronged strategy. One is looking at the recurring consumer, which essentially is looking to come to Z5 for a from a catch-up audience perspective. This is the 500 hours plus of weekly content from the network which comes on the platform. The second point, Arnab, what you mentioned is the original content piece. For us, original defined as something what is exclusively available on Z5 and nowhere else, right? So that's something which you will not find on a linear channels. And lastly, the digital premieres, which is at Z, we've created a property called Theater Ke Baad Pehli Baar. So essentially all the blockbuster movies, which will come straight from the big screens, from your multiplexes, straight to the OTT platforms without even hitting the linear television channels. So this three-pronged strategy is really working for us.
I'm saying if you go a little platform agnostic, like if you guys don't talk about your own platform, but if you just talk about from an OTT perspective itself, when there is content that's being created, which is high value, high production, we see a lot of discussion and chatter around, right? But it's not the same case because you cannot keep on creating that kind of content all the time. So the point that I want to derive, and maybe for the audience as well, is do you think that we will only remain the blockbuster kind of a game, or no, there is a regular possibility of consuming beyond catch-up TV?
Of course. So today, like I said at the start, you know, consumers hungry for good content, right? And their original content plays a very critical role. So of course, high production value and content exclusively for the digital audience becomes very, very critical. Because the digital audience is also looking for the content today, which probably they will not get to watch on television. Could be because of censorship reasons, could be because, you know, it's my space, my time. The second screen and the third screen is very personal for me as an individual. Therefore, original contents play a very critical role in that. When we launched Karanjit Kaur, Sunny Leone's biopic, season one, we saw huge traction for audiences, whether it was from subscription base, viewership, any metric pretty much, right? Because the consumer was looking for that kind of content. And that's where I think if you talk second screen, third screen, original content, in my opinion, will always continue to have a very critical role.
Okay, yeah, please.
Look, for the network content, the strategy is very different. You're not creating fans. The fans are already there on the back of what they're possibly seeing on TV,
right?
What you're doing instead is leveraging the fandom for your digital platform, right? And hence, how you approach your marketing, how you approach the kind of exclusive surround stuff that you create around it, and how you help consumers discover the content that they are already in love with, pretty much forms the cornerstone of your platform strategy. Whereas for your original slash digital first content, new exclusive content, big broad scale, high production value content that you're talking about, that you're alluding to, over there, the rule is very, very different. Over there, you are creating fandom. You have to create fans, you have to create conversations, because there is no existing fandom that's already there in the market, right?
No, and it's a very interesting point, you know, and I want to move to Neha and, you know, ask a question that I think Akash just rightly mentioned, and even Manish did, like, that fans are already there and the fandom exists. There is madness about content. People are needy about content. Now, in that kind of a space, how do you think advertising in a platform like yours, or in general, when you're having that kind of an experience, aren't the ads really intrusive at that point in time?
That's a very interesting question. First, to address the fans, it'll be very difficult to understand and very hard to believe that how discerning the audiences have become now. And if I'm a fan of a Netflix content, if I liked, for example, Sacred Games, or the next time if I don't see my kind of content being marketed, I'm going to move to another space. So while we are building communities, I think the biggest question OTT players need to ask is what kind of content viewers are willing to pay for. Having said that, if you've come up with a model of absolutely no ads first up, and I just recently have heard the news that Netflix is going to come up with a hybrid model of, freemium kind of a content, it's very difficult to understand how the loyal viewers of Netflix would react to that, because they've always had a very enriching experience. While it may get some new viewers for them, definitely, but like I said earlier, people are willing to pay for an enriching experience. Time immemorial, brands have gotten to content, sometimes contextually, sometimes not contextually. But what we do with our technology, which is totally AI-based and machine learning, we are highly non-disruptive. And that's what we pride ourselves in. And if anybody saw Sacred Games and saw one, if anybody remembers that cola brand in Sacred Games that came in the first episode, it was put it in the content as if it was always there. And that's what we really do. It's the future for advertising.
Sure. So I think it's just getting interesting. While we are talking about creating experiences which I think are completely man-made, we are talking about an AI-based solution to monetize it. To come back to you, Manish, if you want to just give us a little more information in terms of the industry and its size. And where do you think, like, in next 5 years, like, we're talking about a 2,000 crore industry at this point in time in India, which is pegged at like 5,000 crore in terms of just OTT content, et cetera. Where do you see the industry going in terms of ad revenues, in terms of, even more money is being put in creating content, original or catch up?
Okay, I'll answer that question slightly differently for you. So two data points. One, if you look at the latest PwC report, it says by 2020, 80% of the consumers are going to be SVOD driven. And so, which means, the point also which Neha raised, consumers are going to be willing to pay for it. And we have room for all. So what I mean is that you want to pay slightly less or want to watch free content, you will be okay with that occasional ad burst within the content. At the same time, if you want a seamless, uninterrupted experience, you don't mind paying that premium. So that's one. Second, if you look at it from an overall category space perspective, of course, key players who continue to produce and give that enriching user experience will thrive over and above anybody else. But net-net, it's going to be a completely behind-the-paywall kind of industry, and we are already moving towards that. We're seeing not just for us and pretty much for everybody else in the category, it is SVOD which is actually driving today numbers for everyone.
Right. Akash, you want to add to it?
I have a slightly contrarian view to this. Yeah. I think it's too early for us to start predicting where the world is increasingly going to move towards, whether AVOD or SVOD, because very clearly, at this level, currently, the digital advertising market is only about 17%, so it's still a very under-penetrated market. But what we are very clearly seeing are the huge tailwinds with respect to where the consumers are spending more and more time of theirs, which is on watching videos online, right? And we all know the data points, close to 70% plus odd consumption, or 70% plus odd of time spent of a consumer every day is actually happening on online videos. And the second, the big data point very clearly is being seen is that the huge growth for most of the platforms are not only coming from your big metro states or metro cities, but a huge growth is actually happening from your surround towns, your tier 2, tier 3, and of course, the new rural markets, which are only opening up right now. For a lot of these new consumers, when they come in for the first time, I don't know to what extent they will be that much more forthcoming in immediately start paying money to start watching content. Because let's get one thing very clear, TV is not going anywhere very, very soon. Right, TV is very, very clearly here to stay. Even in the TV market, there's a huge growth that's going to happen because even TV households only has a 64%, 65% odd penetration. So that's one part of the story. The second part of the story very clearly is that advertisers will continue to only increase their spends on digital. And when we talk about advertisers, we are talking about platforms which are going to run ads. And at a very, very basic level, we are talking about, to some extent, the AVOD platforms, right? And advertisers are now, and I just want to make a separate point over here. What advertisers are very clearly realizing that maybe a 30-second TV ad is not going to really build brand loyalty by any measure. Because increasingly, the favorite brands of a consumer is not what comes in the form of a big, huge, flamboyant, flashy 30-seconder ad, but it is what Google tells you what is most relevant for you at a given point in time, which forces you to purchase.
Let me just complete.
And hence, there's a huge focus on digital performance advertising, which is called as a digital ROI advertising. Right. But on the other side, advertisers are also realizing that we are still talking about human beings, right? And for human beings, it is stories which does the trick. And we saw the previous session where the Perfetti MD spoke at length about content marketing. So advertisers will continue to spend disproportionate amount of money on both the ROI side of the business and also on the content marketing side. And if that happens, the advertising market is only going to grow up. Yeah. For the
so,
online.
So just before you even keep down your microphone, I want you to add three things you think content marketers should keep in mind in this entire OTT game or even the content marketing space. And I want all three of you to tell three things that us content marketers should keep in mind.
Me? Oh, heart attack. Okay. So I think what you said is just right. I think with the content viewing habits changing drastically, the way advertisers are going to spend their money is also going to change. Like you rightly said, AVOD model will sustain along with SVOD. But we've done a lot of research and, you know, the general tendency going forward for digital audiences specifically is to look at the content and avoid the ads. While they are going to get the customers there, but they're going to look at innovative ways of really reaching out to them. And there's something called the subliminal advertising, which is a very, very important tool today to reach out along with a 30-second or a 10-second ad today. And that's extremely potent and passive form of advertising, which I believe is going to soon emerge as a very important line item in a planning process for an advertiser when they're planning media campaigns today.
Great. We have very little time, so chop, three points.
Yeah. 2 points, quickly. First one, what Neha spoke about, the subliminal advertising. I think one of the big issues, one of the big challenges that every content marketer currently is facing is how do you measure that, right? We marketers, we advertisers, we all love to measure whatever is there of the consumer's head. But unfortunately, you know, you could very clearly do that for a 30-second TVC, but very difficult to do that for a subliminal advertising.
Akash,
unless you are measuring the yes. mind batters.
Yes.
Right?
So that's what we are doing. So when we say that Myriads actually puts video, we embed videos, brand videos within the content, it's actually not a product placement. It's an ad unit, which is a global currency of a 10-seconder, which is measurable, trackable, and researchable. Sure. And
different
that's
formats.
What the difference that we are creating in the market, and I'm proud to say that we are the first ones who are doing that. Okay. And that's a real disruptor.
Okay. One data point and two things to keep in mind. Currently, you are at about 390 million internet users. Next 300, 400 million growth is going to come only at the back of language. So three things which will really help one grow: voice, video, and vernacular is what I would say one needs to focus on.
Great. So and video. Okay.
And video.
We can take some questions from the audience if you have, or else I'll just summarize what we spoke about. Anybody, any question?
I can't hear you, sorry.
Can you give the mic for her?
Hi, yeah, I have a question for Neha.
Hi.
I'm a content creator and a producer, and you had mentioned earlier that I think you said $500 million of funding is available, or did you say $1 billion?
Louder, please.
Might be available. I'm not sure if the mic is working or not, but for content creators, original content creators, what is the source of those funds? Is that primarily brands? Is it investment? Where does somebody like me access those funds?
If
you can repeat your question, yeah. Okay. Okay.
I think that's what I read in the PwC report. First of all, the biggest investment that is being made by is from the likes of Netflix and Amazons of the world in original content, and of course,
Boot and Z5 as well.
And I was coming to that. And the biggest, linear players are highly investing in original content. Not to forget all Balaji's and TVFs of the world who are producing so much of original content. Yeah. And while they are getting the audiences who are on linear, on their catch up, which is a great strategy, like Akash said, TV is nowhere to go. Only the medium to consume TV is going to shift from one screen to the other because of the access of more and more, data at a very cheaper rate. But at the same time, so I feel the millennial audience is so underserved right now in terms of relevant content that they are the ones who are really pushing big players to enter into original content. And like someone rightly mentioned in the panel, that original is a misnomer. It could be original production. It could be a great exclusive that you bring to India. When Netflix had gone ahead and bid for House of Cards, it was a whopping $100 million acquisition, and a lot of industry experts thought that will they ever make money? They had to actually get 5 or 6 million odd new subscribers to break even. They ended up getting almost 20 million new guys.
Thank you, Neha. Sorry, guys, we are running out of time, so we can't take any more questions. I'll just quickly wrap. Firstly, thank you, everybody, for spending your time. I think what clearly came out that TV is nowhere to go, and OTT platforms are going to augment experiences for audiences. I think we'll keep on investing into creating content and experiences for consumers because we are younger as a nation, and therefore they are in need of content. New formats of advertisements are coming up, especially that Neha represent and many others, that you're aware of. I think we have to keep in mind what Manish mentioned, that we have to remember that the next 300, 400 million internet users are possibly not so fluent in English and even in Hindi. So vernacular is the way. So there will be a lot of regional content which is going to come up targeting the audiences. And I think also what Akash mentioned, it kind of resonates with, I think we have to keep experimenting, we have to keep doing new stuff. If we start looking for trends and data points, it's too early for us to even look at that. We have to just, have the fun of creating and keep creating, and I think that's really what the session is. So if I have to just close it, we are talking about sustainable future in terms of content, and it's only possible when you keep on creating content, because for the joy of creating content and keeping in mind the audience and their need and their languages. So thank you very much for listening to us, and hope that it made some sense. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for that fantastic panel discussion. I'd like to invite Ms. Winky Singh, Director of Bio Ayurveda, to please join me on stage to present a token of our appreciation to our panelists. Thank you so much once again to our panelists. And Ms. Singh, thank you very much for doing the honor.